All kinds of substances and particles from urban activity accumulate on road surfaces, walls, and roofs. Although the rain cleans the atmosphere and city surfaces, these substances and particles pass through the drainage system and end up in the environment mostly untreated. The CityPol project, funded by the European Next Generation Programme, aims at understanding how the water cycle is impacted by cities. This involves various case studies in the Basque municipalities of San Sebastian and Usurbil, and in the Catalan municipalities of Girona and Viladecans.
CityPol plantea estudiar precisamente el impacto de las aguas pluviales urbanas que están lavando un montón de superficies de, digamos, de las casas, los pavimentos, las calles, residuos que entran desde la atmósfera o que simplemente por la actividad de las personas que viven en el espacio urbano, pues van quedando sobre estos depósitos, digamos, estas estructuras urbanas.
The water regime in the cities where the study has been conducted is very different. In San Sebastian, on the shores of the Cantabrian Sea, it rains on average 185 days per year. The average rainfall in the city is 1,474 liters per year.
Afecta molt la intensitat de la pluja perquè és molt diferent que tinguis unes pluges de manera continuada, de manera progressiva, que vagin escampant perquè fa que va arrossegant els contaminants i no deixa que es vagin acumulant els nous contaminants. Que seria una mica la situació que està passant aquí en el cas d'estudi del projecte d'aquí de Donosti.
In Girona, 749 liters of rain are collected annually, and it rains on average 127 days per year. The average rainfall is less than half of the average rainfall in San Sebastian. And this year, 2024, it has rained much less due to the severe droughts the region is suffering. The scientists have had difficulty collecting the intended samples.
Aquest matí hem vingut a recollir l'aigua de la pluja que va caure ahir. I bàsicament el que hem fet és recollir mitjançant aquest aparell l'automostrejador, que el que fas, tu el pots programar cada cert temps i poder agafar diferents mostres d'aigua. En aquest cas tenim 24 ampolles i podem omplir aquestes 24 ampolles amb un cert temps de diferència. En aquest cas nosaltres volem mostrejar el first flush, que és les primeres aigües que baixen durant un episodi de pluges.
They collect the first flush that reaches the drainage system after a downpour. The sampling devices have been set up at different points in the rainwater network, which receives rainwater from different types of areas. In this case, it comes from a car park of a large shopping center where the traffic is heavy. The study has kindled the interest of municipal teams. In San Sebastian, they've been holding regular meetings with the scientists. The city has a mixed rainwater collection system. In some areas, the rainwater combines with the sewage water, while in the more modern neighborhoods, it is channeled through separate, more environmentally efficient networks.
Las zonas antiguas, esa recogida se hace junto con la red de saneamiento de fecales y termina en la depuradora, y otra parte de la red de pluviales que vierte directamente a los cauces o regatas que o terminan en el río o terminan en diferentes puntos de salida al mar.
In view of the potential negative effects of urban runoff, systems for collecting solids have been installed in areas with heavy traffic or industrial activity. But the CityPol project explores the impact of the most difficult to separate contaminants, the ones deposited on urban surfaces as particles, dust, or liquids.
Bueno, para el Ayuntamiento de San Sebastián tiene importancia, sobre todo si tenemos en cuenta que nuestras playas, en las que vierten esos cauces, vemos el nivel de contaminación que tiene y pues para tener adecuado el baño de las personas, etc.
Biologists, engineers, chemists, a multidisciplinary team is involved in the CityPol project. The reason is that besides finding out what reaches the natural environment via the urban runoff, they have set out to analyze the potential biological effects.
Hortik aparte nahi duguna da, ze eragin biologiko sortzen diren. Azteko bai, deskribapen kimikoa da helburuetako bat, hau da jakitea zer iristen den eta ze konzentrazioetan, baina biologoa gara eta gure helburua proiektuaren barruan ikustea da izaki bizionetan ze eragin daukan. Potentzialki ba, askuntzan, ugalketan, biziraupenean, ba, izakietan, izaki bizionetan izan dezakeen eragina aztertzea.
In a rainy basin such as that of San Sebastian, it is difficult to know how much rain falls in a given area of the city during a rainfall event. The cooperation of the Municipal Fire Brigade enabled simulating a standard rainfall event and monitoring its consequences.
Euri egiten duenean, zonalde konkretu baten zenbat euri egiten egondan neurtzea ez da hain erresa eta jakitea zenbat denbora egon diren kutsatzaileak metatzen ez da ere. Orduan egiten duguna da honen bitartez, izan da nolabait erregulatu edo neurtu guk nahi genuen ur kantitate bat jakiteko zenbat kontzentraziotan eta zenbateraino diluituta egongo diren kutsatzaile horiek gure laginetan.
The old part of San Sebastian, the city police car park in the Egara district, or the residential district of Moorlands have been washed with the help of the fire brigade, just as the rain would do during a heavy downpour. For further analysis, all the samples need to be carefully identified. Both the rainwater collected in Girona and that sampled in San Sebastian were studied at the Catalan Institute for Water Research, ICRA. Advanced analytical techniques able to detect over 1,000 different compounds have made it possible to determine the contaminant compounds swept away by the rainwater.
Contaminantes de diferentes tipos. La mayoría vienen de tráfico, de coches, de desgasto de ruedas. Después son compuestos, por ejemplo, de pesticidas que se utilizan en jardines urbanos o insecticidas. También drogas veterinarias, fármacos veterinarios, por ejemplo, porque nuestras mascotas, cuando salen, hacen necesidades y al final se detectan también fármacos veterinarios y hay muchos contaminantes.
The contaminants collected in both cities are very similar. The concentration so far measured is no cause for alarm, although a higher concentration is detected in samples collected early on during the rain event. 150 different contaminants in all were detected. Industrial and pharmaceutical contaminants, endocrine disruptors, antibiotics, nicotine derivatives, personal hygiene products, pesticides and herbicides, polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons and metals. Some metals detected, such as nickel, mercury or lead, are regarded as priority substances by the European Water Directive. And others, such as zinc or copper, are regulated because of their potential risk. The concentrations are diluted when the rainwater reaches the rivers, but scientists are drawing attention to the possible effects of chronic exposure and the combination of contaminants.
No tiene que producir un efecto, pero cuando tenemos mezcla de muchos contaminantes presentes en concentraciones bajas, al final tenemos, son posibles efectos o sinergísticos o antagonísticos y al final se detectan efectos a ecosistema acuático. Pero también es cuestión de una exposición a largo plazo. Entonces son efectos crónicos que contaminación en general puede producir en organismos acuáticos.
The field studies were complemented by laboratory experiments such as this one using with an invertebrate species that lives in rivers and usually feeds on leaf litter. The invertebrates were allowed to grow in river water, in rainwater plus river water, and in a mixture of river water and water from a road. They were fed on leaf litter collected in a natural river, in the city, and in a rain-washed urban area. Urban rainwater increased their mortality. In addition, urban leaf consumption was lower. Additionally, streams have been studied in reaches upstream and downstream from rainwater sewers. The conclusions show that urban contaminants carried by rainfall do not have strong effects on the ecosystem, as no clear pattern is observed in the parameters analyzed. However, the research consortium believes that long-term studies are needed, especially as the urban surface area is increasing worldwide.
Gero eta gehiago okupatzen ari gara, gero eta jende gehiago bizi gara, jarduera gehiago dauzkagu, eta jarduera horiek gero eta produktu kimiko gehiagotan oinarritzen dira. Orduan, produktu kimiko askoren zikloak edo bilakaerari buruz informazio oso gutxi daukagu.
Thermal insulation, building materials, paints, toxic products from industry or traffic. Materials used in cities are continually being washed away by the rain.
Cada vez somos más urbanos, cada vez estamos más sometidos al impacto de muchos nuevos materiales que estamos fabricando, que están llegando al medio, que estamos ingiriendo, que nos están llegando vía respiratoria, etcétera, etcétera. Y como nosotros, los organismos que viven en los ríos.